this and the counter would be that. And yeah. Like, imagine the thought, like, I'm just going to slap Chris Rock, one of the greatest stand-up comedians of all time. It's not like he's going to tear my very vulnerable life apart after I smack him with some of the best comedy that anybody's ever written. And he's going to hone it over a year before he releases it.
Yo, Sailor, how are you doing, man? You hear have bad looks, heavy breathing? Yeah, it's coughing, man. How are you guys doing? I'm just chilling before I have to go to work today. I noticed a lot of shit went down yesterday. Ghosty came back in my Discord. Jalen had a meltdown. There's an echo? Oh yeah, that should be fixed now. It's 3 a.m. where I am. Yeah, it's like around 5 a.m. where I am right now. I start work at 7, so... But I always have to leave like roughly like 40 minutes before I get to work, so... That's rough. So formal, I saw that you like ran Ghosty out of my server. You and Ember. Oh yeah, I caught a little bit of it, but that was pretty actually funny. And then Ghosty News Team for Life. Did you see that guy who so I made a tweet about Salvo and some guy called me brain dead because I feel like he actually thought I fucking was serious about that whole thing. I actually like hate when people can't tell something's like obviously a fucking troll and then they're like, look at how retarded this guy is. I actually hate that shit. I don't know why. Maybe it's a pet peeve. Maybe I'm tired. Maybe that's why I like can't fucking stand it. Did you like my Mr. Beast versus Destiny tweet? The one that you just posted, Sailor? Here, one sec. Yeah, this one? I spent way too much time on it. Here, one sec.
Destiny recently said that when women friend zone men, that's emotional rape. Just really great takes all around. So happy he's influencing so many young men. I've got more sway than self-victimizing losers like you who have zero audience and zero influence. There's a reason young men ditched you virgin fucks years ago for Red Pill creators. Don't mind me working to undo your cancer. Go back to your cuck corner making video essays. I made a stupid decision coming for Destiny on Twitter, which stemmed from a genuine care for the woman community, but I was woefully unprepared to debate him, so I...
Hey guys, what's up?
Mr. Beard is crying on Twitter again.
Oh God, Mr. Beard, I believe it was time someone had a fireside chat with you. You're acting more irrational than Lav. After Abba called her a few names.
I don't need a fireside chat. Destiny's audience is 99%
How long
men
does it take
because
for
women
you to
don't
want to
watch someone make incel arguments about...
I'm going to stop you right there, Beardy boy. You're taking what Destiny said at face value and not giving him any benefit of the doubt, seemingly because you have a vendetta from the non-binary debate.
That's not true. Oh, thank God, a neutral party.
I'm not neutral, bitch. Remember when Yo Gerber baby-looking ass said I was a big fan of capitalism, then complained about people not seeing the nuance in your argument? Yeah, real ironic, considering the current situation. Sit down
oh,
before
yeah.
I get fatphobic, or as you would call it, fascist.
Yeah,
dumb woodchip-eating loser, he left Olmao.
The Mr. Beast part was fucking great, actually. So yeah, I'm still upkeeping on the workout thing. I ended up working out before streaming. I mean, like, quotation, like, I'm just doing fucking yoga. But, hey, it's something. God, it took me 2 hours. That's fucking rough, because I had to get samples from all the people. That is rough. Also, formal, my VC is open if you want to pop in. I have, like, technically, like, I said I'd, like, pull people in. Fuck, I'm getting, like, I'm not getting destroyed. I'm just being fucking dramatic about this right now. But, by the way, if you're new to the stream, I got a hot tub donation fund going. I'm gonna hot tub stream with Murdoch, and, everyone who donates will get a say on the Speedo I wear for the hot tub stream. I guess Tim's not here, so the donation link isn't, like, available or something. I don't know. He says it pops up on his phone, but I don't fucking know. But yeah, there's our goal down below for the hot tub stream. Anyways, so I'm playing 2K23. Oh, WWE, that makes sense. Yo, are you playing as Logan Paul? I hope you are. You better be playing as Logan Paul. If I could play that game, that's all I would play as. Logan Paul. I'd make Jake Paul. Absolutely perfect. Yeah, no. I remember wrestling games being actually pretty fun. I can't lie. I, like, played a few of them. I know Dr. Uberhausen had me play a few of them. I'm gonna head to bed. Have a great morning. Thanks a lot, Sailor. That was a funny edit you did, bro. Have a good night, eh? My first match was Brock Lesnar versus Logan Paul. Oh my god. That'd be like, oh, I'm trying to remember who Brock Lesnar is. One sec. I think it's who I think it is, but... What is it, Brock Lesnar? Oh my gosh. That guy destroyed him. Like, they're totally different. For some reason, when you said Brock Lesnar, I was thinking of that big black guy. I forget what his name was, but he was like a giant guy with a bald head. My wrestling knowledge isn't the best anymore. Let's say Logan Paul ended up like the body of the forest. That's good. Gosh. Oh, what does he say in that video? He's like, ooh. Oh my gosh, that's good. So, yeah, how'd you guys run Ghosty on my server again? Formal. I saw you and Ember Lily were going at him. I think it was Grim as well. Kind of went at him pretty bad. If I was Logan Paul, I would have made the situation even worse. I would have used the dead body like a puppet. How would you have used it like a puppet? Would you have, like, shoved your hand up the body? Or would you have, like, gone behind and, like, kind of, like, acted like a ventriloquist? There's so many ways you could take that comment. None of them good. Oh shit. Opened up Microsoft Edge, guys. There we go. Hashtag, you know those puppets with the strings at the top? And use the nose to make the body jiggle. Oh my god. This is getting worse and worse, Formal. Oh gosh. That's awful. That's actually fucking terrible. I mean, it fits the situation because the individual hung themselves, I believe. But, like, god damn, bro. That is some terrible fucking shit. Formal, what type of speedo would you want me to wear for the hot tub stream? Do you think the Borat one is appropriate? Logan was literally making jokes about the dead body. Was he? It's been a long time since I saw the video. I would pull it up on Twitch, but I feel like you obviously can't pull that type of video up on this platform. I know it's like all over the place, though. It's not actually hard to find that video. You tried to delete it, but once it's on the internet, it's always on there. But, I guess formally you don't really care about the Jalen stuff, do you? Jalen basically had a meltdown in a group chat of ours. I think it was called, like, the Spurg Society Death Battles or some shit. And, I think the Borat run is perfect at all. I think Missionary Sundays will get a lot spicier. Absolutely. I told Kaylee about it last night. She literally responded with, what the fuck is wrong with you? But she said she'd help with the stream at least. I have no idea what happened with Jalen. So basically Jalen went off yesterday on like everyone. Because again, I said she is in a group chat that we're all in called Spurg Society Death Battle. And it was about like a month or two ago when like she's like in kind of like a dark place. It was around the same time she was having all the no, she didn't say the N-word again. But it was around the time when she was doing the debates with Anchito and stuff like that. And she ended up like going in kind of like a dark place. And she was talking about copy striking people's like YouTube videos and shit like that. And, you know, like, it was all kind of kept private in the group chat because we talked her out of it and all that shit. But then someone leaked all the chats yesterday, which caused her to fucking spiral out of control. She went off on, like, everyone. If I was her PR manager, I would tell her to say the N-word as much as possible. Fair enough. I mean, it's one way. Look at iDubbbz, which I'm going to talk about that fuck in a few minutes. But, yeah, so basically Jalen, like, spiraled, went off on everyone. Accused everyone for leaking DMs and all that. But then somehow, like, came to the conclusion that it was AD30 who leaked the DMs of the group chat. And, called AD30 out for being like a slimy person and all this shit and a snake. Then she went at him in Discord and did the same thing and then fucking blocked everyone. I honestly think Idubbbz did nothing wrong in the situation he was talking about. Oh, Idubbbz? Really? Wait a minute, okay. Idubbbz situation's more interesting to me than Jalen anyway. So, like, what do you mean? Like, for Idubbbz saying the N-word? Or for, like, how Idubbbz ended up now? Like, do you still like Idubbbz, Formal? Because I honestly, like, I get the whole, like, girlfriend thing. Like, it's easy to chirp someone because they have a girlfriend and all that. But, like, I do think he is a hypocrite. He grew apart from the weird audience he was growing. Like, I guess. Like, that's what I mean. Like, at the end of the day, it's like a real fucking human being. I'm not going to chirp him for having a girlfriend and, like, doing that sort of stuff. And I get, like, branching away from his old audience. But, like, I do get, like, the criticism when people get pissed when they're, like, he tries not to acknowledge it at all. Because he was the guy who was known for saying the N-word. And, like, for fucking, like, showing up to Tana Mongu or whatever the fuck her name was. Oh, there is Tim up. Want to join the conversation, Stream Elements? Normally, Tim does all that shit, like, on his own. I wonder if he's lurking. He probably knew I started streaming. And was like, oh fuck, Chad's gonna fucking stream without me and he's gonna fuck his whole stream setup. He probably like woke up from a dead sleep. It has nothing to do with his girlfriend because she was there during the good times. She literally helped him film the Really? I did not know that, actually. I did not know that she was part of the content cop, actually. Not Trisha, I forgot her name. It's Tana Mongu, or whatever, you know, Jake Paul's fake MTV wife, where they had that stupid fucking wedding that apparently Salvo went to. I still don't know if I believe Salvo on that or not, but... Yeah, she literally filmed him saying the N-word. Wow, I didn't know that they went, like, that far back, actually. Because she was a streamer too, wasn't she? I know they're both Canadian and shit, but... Like, she's not my cup of tea, I'll say that, but... She's like that type of girl, like... If you're at a party with all of them together, she's like that type of girl where I feel like you'd have to watch what you say at the party because she'd, like, go off, but you allow her at the party because she's, like, your friend's girlfriend. You know what I mean? I guess that's like a douchebag thing to say, but whatever. I said it. I said what I said. I have no regrets in life. But yeah, that's news to me. I didn't know that she was there and filmed his shit. He even said it during the interview with Anthony Padel. Yeah, he did. Oh, like that she was there filming him, or Anthony? Wait, Anthony Padel is the Smosh dude, isn't it? I can't remember. There's so many fucking YouTubers that, like, you have to keep track of. Well, you don't have to keep track of it, but... What the fuck do you spell his last name? Padel. Anthony Padel. Oh, yeah, it's a stupid fucking Smosh guy. He kind of looks like a Jonas brother. Oh, there's the Idubbbz interview. Idubbbz addresses controversial past. They spent a day with Idubbbz. They should have done, like, that comedian in Cars thing where they drove around the city. Like, she was there the whole time, was doing all that edgy stuff. I loved him in Smosh the movie. I've never actually seen that stuff. I wasn't, like, a big Smosh fan. Not for, like, any particular reason. I'm not gonna come out and be like, I thought Smosh was gay and all that shit. No, I just, honestly, just never really watched Smosh. It's gonna sound bad, but I watched probably more Nisseon than I did, like, Smosh. Back in the day. I'm gonna watch that interview, though, at work, actually. That's, I did not know it was, like, posted. I thought it was some, like, gay, like... Me, I grew up on Smosh. Like, I knew it was Smosh, but... They were, like... What, generation 2 of YouTube. Like, they were huge. They're like, one of the first, like, groups of YouTubers to make like a company of what they did, wasn't it? Nah, it's not cringe. Not cringe at all, bro. I used to watch Philip DeFranco. That's cringe. That's like the one where like you don't want to tell people about. I can't fucking stand that guy now. He has more fucking cuts than like a 13-year-old YouTuber in his fucking videos. But early YouTube shit, what did I watch? I used to watch a lot of JonTron, Angry Nintendo Nerd. Well, I guess like, yeah, Angry Nintendo Nerd back in the day. I don't know, just kind of random things. I don't think, here's my thing. I wonder if Ian and Anthony still talk. I don't know, that's a good question. Does like Ian still talk to like H3H3 and shit like that though? Cause like he like used to know like PewDiePie, Boygore, or not Boygore, what's it, Boygore? Who's that rapper? Who's the rapper one that did like fucking the school song? God, I don't even fucking know. Not Boygore though. Boygore is the one who did the rap song with Miley Cyrus. Oh my gosh. I don't know. He had, like, red hair. He did, like, he was part of the Rice Gum video. Boy in a Band! That's it, Boy in a Band. Yeah, I wonder if he, like, talks to that whole crew still. Epic Lloyd? No. Oh, yeah, I used to watch, whatever that's called. Epic Rap Battles. I used to watch a lot of Epic Rap Battles. I thought those guys were fucking funny. I used to, like, know off by heart the Hitler Darth Vader one. Actually. Those are like the good old days, like getting fucking stoned and singing like shitty rap songs. I feel like I can make a rap song about like singing shitty rap songs back in the old days. On my old Twitter, I used to have a Epic Rap Battles of History follow me. That's pretty sick, actually. That's kind of a flex. How did you get them to follow you? Was it just like one of those random fucking things where they just followed you? Oh, I totally stole that guy's fucking bones. Is the funniest way I got them to follow me, I just went to the DMs and asked them if I could get a follow. I've debated on doing that again with this new Twitter. I mean, are they even like really still like doing anything? I know like occasionally, like I feel like they release like a new song like once a year. I'm temporarily on a break from Twitter. It's WrestleMania season. I need to stay in the loop of shit. Also, like honestly, nothing really happens on Twitter. Like, when you quit Twitter for a bit, I get why. Especially, like, if you're not making YouTube videos and shit. Like, the only reason I have to go on Twitter is just to actually, like, find what is going on and what is, like, trending. But, like, at the end of the day, like, I don't actually find, like, Twitter fun. I actually kind of find it stressful in a way. If that makes sense. But, like, that's kind of why, like, I start to, like, dissociate myself with some like these commentary spurts. Like I'm in all the group chats and shit with them and all the fucking discords, but like I don't really say anything. I just kind of lurk in them because like I don't know, it's kind of like the same thing with my channel. I don't really care about talking about like online spurgs anymore, shit like that. I find it all boring. I just honestly think they're retarded. I'd much rather like talk about like a specific topic or like actually debate a topic or just do something fun. That's why I don't do drama content. I only make content about nerdy shit, right? And that's like kind of the shitty thing is they find like it's easier to gain a following doing drama shit and then eventually branch it out into like stuff you want to do. Like it's gonna sound bad formal, but like it's kind of like the tactic I'm doing right now is like I'm involved in like the commentary community and all this shit because like you can pull in small audiences and stuff like that and eventually start to build yourself up. But, like, honestly, if I was to, like, sort of pop off, you know what I mean? I would absolutely, like, branch and do my own shit. Like, I like doing stupid shit on the internet and, like, funny stuff. Like, talking about drama shit and all the time. It gets so boring. It gets old. Like, it honestly, like, half the time is just fucking depressing. Because, like, it always boils down to someone having a mental health crisis or some shit like that. Like, that last stream we did was, like, so fucking funny. Like, I would love to do, like, story time streams and just, like, talk about fucking, like, sex stories and stupid stories and shit like that over drama content any fucking day. Only reason I'm in the commentary community is because there's cool people in it, like the Park and Tigers. But, like, at the end of the day, they're not really commentary, though, you know what I mean? I'd argue that, like, CJ is probably the most, like, commentary-orientated. I love the storytime streams. You know, I was telling Kaylee about it. I think I agreed with her, like, the next time we both come on to stream together, we'll do, like, a storytime stream. I just want to make sure no one's waiting in my waiting room. I don't have Tim. I'm on my own. But yeah, it's not that, like, I don't hate commentary stuff. Like, I do topic commentary literally on YouTube and shit. It's just, to me, it's kind of like a means to the end. Like, I don't necessarily find playing video games like the most entertaining person at all, like, or thing at all either. Because I'm not someone who watches Let's Plays either, so I'd love to just be, like, full out, like, just entertainment at the end of the day. If I could, like, have a choice on, like, where my Twitch channel would end up or YouTube. And it's kind of ironic because I think, like, I have more subscribers on YouTube, but I find my Twitch channel pays off more. Like, I do find there's more of a reason to stream than there is to make YouTube videos, but maybe that's just me. I don't know. I gotta tell you this hilarious thing about the wrestling game. They have multiple versions of John Cena through his wrestling career, and there's one of the versions that's just an invisible John Cena. That's funny. I used to live in Ottawa, and they used to actually get, like, WWE, and I mean, it's still, like, small WWE, like, Canadian WWE, but John Cena was there, but it was, like, so long ago where he wore, like, the green camo pants, and he had the chain where he, like, spanned the fucking medallion, and I have no idea what fucking year that was with him, but that was the only time I've ever seen wrestling live. I did used to be a Raw fan. I never really watched SmackDown, but I definitely used to watch a decent amount of Raw. Was this the rapper John Cena? I think so. It was when he had that, like, medallion thing that, like, span around. And then he had, like, a green, like, almost like trucker hat or some shit like that. And, like, camo, like, shorts. That's all I remember about him. I think he was fighting Edge at the time. It was either, like, Edge or Randy Orton who he is fighting. Fun fact about John Cena is that he has a rant album that is, I think, certified diamond, really. He's, like, actually, like, out of all the wrestlers, I think, like, one of the guys who was, like, super chill in IRL, though. Oh, rap album. Okay, yeah, never mind. Sorry, I'm just dumb. Yeah, I think I knew that. Let's see. See if I can pull it up. John Cena's rap album. Oh, it's literally called You Can't See Me, debut album by WWE wrestler John Cena and his cousin, The Trademark. Did it really get diamond, though? I guess 2005 it came out. That's wild. That's so cool, though. I actually, like, I don't know. Wrestling was, like, a guilty pleasure back in the day for me. It's either Dime or Gold, I don't remember. Yeah, but it's still fucking funny regardless. He actually created an album. I remember when Booker T tried to sing a song. I know, it's so fucking funny. Or King Booker, I guess, at the time. That was like, I don't know, when I watched wrestling, what was it? When I actually like watched wrestling. Also, you may want to listen to this while you're at work, but Macho Man Randy Savage also has a rap album. In one song, is a diss track against Hollywood Hulk. Yeah, no, normally I can get away with watching it later, like listen to stuff at work, so maybe actually. Basically, the first 2 hours and the last 2 hours of my shift are busy, and then the rest of them is to make sure no one fucking dies. Is like the flow of my shift. I'll also be streaming tomorrow morning as well, too. By the way, I'm gonna try to stream on days where I have to work in the mornings. My fucking cereal is soggy and it's so gross. Now? But yeah, what else did I say I was gonna talk about? Oh, Justin Minx. So I was following like the whole Justin Minx thing. I know we did the like hot or not situation. I still think she's a banger, but I guess at that like streamer awards thing, she promised not to be fucking wasted, and she ended up showing like fucking pissed drunk and all that. And then they went to a after party. Her and QT Cinderella. And the girl was like, right, fuck. She reminds me of like, those like classic white girls that get like too drunk at places or at house parties. I mean, we've all seen them, you know? Where they're like dramatic and drunk and like, I don't know. I think Justin Minx can actually like pound back her liquor. But I've seen like girls that have had like four fucking coolers and act the same way. But, she's an absolutely queen, okay? She's piss-face drunk. Right, I think, like, okay, so I actually, like, low-key think Justin Minx is probably, like, a fun person to chill with, and I would. But, like, not at your house, if you know what I mean. I feel like she's the type of girl that would, like, trash her whole fucking place and then leave. But, like, at a club or a bar or some shit, I feel like she'd be hilarious. But I guess at this party, she was grabbing the, you know, like, the big, tall, 8-foot, 7-foot lights, like, the torches that are, like, propane-powered? Like, she's Irish. I expect this of her. She gets this a pass. She's, like, she's Irish, which is the whole reason why you invite her to the party for these, like, situations. That's funny. I get that, actually. I would have, sometimes, I've been, like, shady like that and invited someone to a party where, like, you only invite them because shit's gonna happen. But, yeah, I guess she was trying to, throw, like, one of those fucking lights into the pool. She was, like, trying to toss people in the pool. All this shit. And then, like, when they tried to pull her out, she, went, like, limp. But that's when she argued that it was a seizure. But she ended up getting, like, the whole party shut down. Firefighters came to the house. I guess it was, like, a situation where there's, like, neighbors on the front lawn, like, in the neighborhood watching, like, Justin Minx get fucking, like, carried out by, like, her arms and legs and shit like that. It was so funny. I was, listening to, Drama Alert's, like, rundown of it, and, like, it makes sense, because I saw the tweets before, like, Drama Alert, like, made their statement about it, but, she just sounds like a white girl who got too fucking wasted and didn't want to go home. The thing I want to talk. Did you see Bunk talk about abortion the other day? So I did see the thread, but I don't know much about it. Cause wasn't he arguing against Destiny or something? I can pull it up. One sec. I saw the whole, like, I saw him, like, going off on people, but I didn't really see, like, what it was all about. The thing that... Okay, here it is. What is that? I just wanna... I'll switch back, so... Bunk actually looks like, what's his name? Leonardo DiCaprio, if he has, like, a butterface. I gotta get my Hill Giants XP in, sorry. I tried to help Jalen and to come, or to come to better positions, but I'm just not capable of people who can't be critiqued by their friends. Oh, is this it? This is not a moral argument. Moral arguments contain outright claims. They're perceptive. Stop pretending you're smart, dumbass. Come onto my show or fuck out my replies if you're identity politics. Is that, like, the whole thread, Formal? No, I thought Bunk was, like, 12 years old the first time. He is a little guy, I will say that. He strikes me as a little guy. I bet you he's, like, probably 19. Or, like, just turned 20, if that's my guess. I've never had a bad interaction with Bunk. I mean, he was, like, pretty funny when, like, in Waterball and stuff, but... Oh, that's not what I was talking about. There's like a video he shared about his girlfriend, or about this girl talking about an abortion and how she was upset that she had the abortion. And he said, just get pregnant again. It's not that hard. Oof. 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 I mean, yeah, she can get pregnant again, sure, but that doesn't, remove the situation that she had the abortion, the emotional fucking baggage that comes with. Yikes, Bunk. Like, okay, so I get, like, what Bunk's saying. It's not, like, over, but he, like, took such a harsh, like, stance on that. Like, abortions, like, one, they physically hurt to get them done, but two, like, they are emotional, especially if you have to, like, get the abortion and you want to keep the kid, is even worse. I mean, if you have the abortion and you just, like, need the abortion because, like, you don't want to have a kid, that's fine. But there still is, like, emotional baggage behind it as well. I think, like, the topic of abortions are always, it's always going to be, like, a heavy topic regardless, like, if you're pro or against. Like, I'll be straight up, like, I'm pro-abortion, but, like, it still sucks to get an abortion. Like, it's not a fun thing to get. And both legs was debating him, saying, like, so people aren't allowed to have feelings about something they regret. And Bone completely left the conversation. I kind of want to see this video. I feel like Bunk fucked up with this one. It's just also, like, it's so, Bo Blacks. It's just completely fucked, though, to, like, disregard the emotional aspect of it, because there absolutely is an emotional aspect of, like, an abortion. Regardless, like, if you're, like, you want to keep the baby or not, there's still, like, an emotional aspect to it. It's not like people run in there, get an abortion, like, woohoo, the baby's gone! No, it's, like, still, it's still, like, emotional, like, to a degree. Like, some people take it better than others, but... I'm curious about this argument now. I find it so weird that he would have the, like, the opposite stance of it, though. In that situation where, like, he, like, disregards, like, emotions so entirely. I'm using voice recognition software to type because I'm too lazy. I'm pro Bo Black. So what, like, Bo Black's is pro, like, the girl's fucking emotion, like, there is emotional, like, baggage to abortion. Is that, like, the stance Bo Black's had? Oh no, it's Jalen. I'll have to find the, I kind of want to find this. God, his feet is so, like, all over the place. It's like fucking abortion, Mr. Girl arguments, and fucking Jalen. It's just fuck, though. Like, I can't understand why he would have such, like, a harsh, like, stance to it, because Bunk is, like, pro-abortion, but, like, to be pro-abortion, you should be aware of, like, everything that does come with abortion, so... Like, you know what I mean? Like, do I sound fucked up saying that, though? But, like, I'm pro-abortions, but I'm not necessarily saying, like, abortions are great or anything. Like, it's not, like, a good thing. It's not, like, necessarily a happy thing. It's just kind of naive of him. I bet you he's, like, I've been with, like, well, like, Kaylee, for example, has had to have an abortion. And, like, we're both pro-abortions, but, like... There's an emotional baggage behind it. So, like, I don't know. I don't get, like, his stance. Yeah, I get what you mean. Like, I'm a pro. I have a college degree. I think everyone that doesn't have a college degree should get a ban. Oh my god. You're gonna create the superior race with that fucking thinking. So nowadays I don't necessarily disagree, though. Fuck. There's some dumb fucking people in this world. How long ago was this, though? This debate? You've given me some things to watch today, Formal. I want to check out the iDubbbz interview, and then I'm also have to stop being lazy and work on the video I said I was going to work on with Plagmoff. I hate doing larger form content now because I find there's never a payoff, but everyone fucking gets mad at me because, like, stop making YouTube shorts, make longer content, and I'm like, but it takes me forever. An 8 to 10 minute video takes me like fucking like 3 or 4 days to get down. It's so annoying. At some point, I'm gonna have to get a RuneScape membership too. I've done like everything I have to do in this game already. I have like, I think 7 mil in the bank. Big bones, bitch. I got like 10 minutes left too for the stream. Just quick chilling streams, you know. Nothing intense. I was shocked to see that Sailor was up still. But like he said, it was 3 a.m. where he was. My goal in my streaming career, by the way, is to eventually get a sponsorship for Meta PC so that you can eventually play Minecraft on this PC. That is my all-time goal. So I can move away from the RuneScape. fucking give me epic rap battles in history? Well, oh, yeah, absolutely. This is, like, epic rap battles in history. I got, like, the same vibe. Come on. This is dope. I like it. What a fucking dope song. What is this made? Wait, one sec. Where is it? Oh, it doesn't even tell you when it was made. Also, goddamn, it's made by Universal. They're gonna take my fucking shit down once I upload on YouTube, I'm sure. Whatever. I don't make fucking money from this shit, so. That's sick, though. 2003? Really? Macho Man was alive in 2003? I thought that guy died in like the fucking 80s. Oh, he died in 2011? He sounded good in 2013, actually, still. Have you been watching any of CJ's streams on Kick? Formal? I saw one of CJ's streams on Kick where he is, like, reviewing Why So Demented's, like, stream or podcast or whatever it was. I was so pissed, though, when I went there and someone had the name Badwick taken. I was fucking, like, actually so pissed. I've been sexually harassing him in the chat as a certain bird character. I mean, you can get away with that on Kick, though. That's why the platform's there. I don't know though. I don't think Kick's good. I think Kick is gonna last for a while. But I don't know if it's gonna like pop off like everyone's saying it will. It's honestly why I stuck with him. CJ is so breedable and submissive, I could just get it. Oh my god. Reminds me of what Ember Lily was saying about him, how he peacocks to some girl. In VC. But yeah, I don't know. I hope, like, Kick, like, I'm always, like, pro, like, have an alternative, like, websites and streaming platforms. I just don't know if Kick's actually gonna, like, kick off. Get it? Ha ha ha! Like, I hope it does. I hope it doesn't end up like Mixer. You know what would be ironic? If Kick was an NFT. I peacocked to CJ Brown. I was, like, kind of still, like, curious about who he peacocks to. Luke was like really fucking making. Oh, I also wrote a diss track on CJ using Eminem voice bot. That's fucking solid. I should get into rapping. I should make like a goal. Like if I hit like 500 Twitch followers, I'll make a rap or some shit. And I'll let like the audience like pick who I make a diss track about. Which, like, I am the worst fucking singer. I am, like, so monotone. Oh my gosh. 6 more levels to go. Oh man, I feel like I can't pull it up on Twitch. Can I? Here, let's see.
I'm gonna smack you in the face and make you frown. CJ Brown, you're gonna go down. I'm gonna smack you in the face and make you frown. CJ Brown, you're gonna go down. I'm gonna smack you in the face and make you frown.
Oh my gosh.
You're gonna go down.
I wish
smack you in the face and make you frown.
It'll be fucking funny if I can make that as a
CJ Brown, you're gonna go down. I'm gonna smack you in the face and make you frown.
If
CJ Brown, you're gonna go down.
Oh god,
I'm gonna smack
repeat.
You in the face and make you frown. CJ
If I, every time someone donated, I could have that play. That'd be fucking hilarious. For, like, the hot tub stream, that'd be so fucking hilarious. Maybe I could get, like, Tim to set that up. Like, every time someone donates any form of money, it just, like, plays that rap. I wanna, like, have more funny things on my stream. I'll have to hit what's it called? Tim up and see if he can set that up. Formal, if can I use it if I give you the credit for it? Woo! Oh yeah. I got incredible reflexes due to religion. Oh, yeah. I can make one of Donald Trump or Ben Shapiro. I do the Donald Trump one. I'm a Trumpie. I'm a Trump fan. That'd be so fucking funny. If you make it formal, I'll send it to Tim whenever you do it. I'll ask him if he could set it up. I think that shit would be fucking hilarious. Alright, after this giant, I got peace! Alright, I'm gonna peace out. Just wanna say thanks, Assistant Sailor, for coming to the chat earlier today. Thanks, Formal, for hanging out with... Fuck, I'm gonna puke. Thanks, Formal, for hanging out with me this morning, man. It was fun. I'll be live, tomorrow before work as well, probably the same time. If you're up around then, just shoot the shit, you know. You can call VC if you want, bro. But yeah, have a good day, man. I'll see you later. Thanks for chilling. Thanks everyone who watches this later on. Quick stream, but it was fun. All right, peace. Time to go work 12 hours.